Okay, let's see what we have today here. So yesterday we tanked down 300 points or so, held support down to 750s. Then gradually grinded more than 50% of this, almost basically 50% of this movement today. We exceeded a little bit more, or between 50% and 61.8% Fibonacci. I don't really use this apart from measure just the distance to catch my gold price. Is trading according to yesterday's or any day's initial rally or big rally or big sell-off. You can see here I have this kind of flag trend line. If this breaks down, price breaks down below initial balance low right here 860s and then retest and hold resistance, then we should see further down. So I'd initially retest down to 800s and then potentially down to this yesterday's low, which coincides with this 50% move from recent highs to ECB lows right here. You can see close to this level price just bounce. Let's see if this happens again. If you would like to see the 1 minute chart here, how it's setting up, I would like to see if price holds below 900, which coincides with initial balance midpoint right here and below volume weighted average price. See if initially you can go down and hold resistance and go further downside for the bear scenario. The other scenario, I would like to see if price can go above hold support here and break out this high, then I would like to buy this for a retest up to 10,000 or even higher. Of course, you can see resistance here and then failure, and then you need to break down all these levels to go for the other scenario as well. Let's see which one will play out. You can see here euro dollar, I'm tracking to see how it will behave here and if it holds this resistance below 113, which is bullish for equities. We can see here bond on the other side, which is initially rallying. Let's see if it takes out this high, which is bearish for equities. If you would like to see the 15 minute chart here on DAX, you can see that price once failed above this high, went straight through this kind of consolidation area, held support kind of below 800. If today we fail to hold and go above this kind of rally up to 10,000, perhaps we can see further downside, because this area here is very well traded, 700 to 800, and if price goes here might just tank lower. Of course this is the bear scenario. Let's see if this happens. So I shorted here at this fake out move above 900s. Let's see if price now can break down this open price and initial balance low and holds below. Then we should see this kind of scenario. Perhaps this can happen. Let's see how it will behave. Very nice breakdown here. You can see initial sell off, then support here for 5 minutes, then consensus with the resistance at this open price. Now selling lower. Let's see if we have further downside. As I showed you earlier, this is kind of flag right here. If it breaks, we're looking to see if price can go at any and hold support at any of these lows, eventually down to the lows of the day. Scale out some of the positions here, perhaps too early. Let's see how price will behave, and if it continues with this pace, we should see straight through 800s. If you would like to just take a look at the big picture here, so I was telling yesterday, you can see this kind of flag broke down. Let's see where we closed just up this kind of 14th of October low 2015 right here. Now trading below, let's see if we managed to take out yesterday's low and where we will generally go. The more it holds below 10,000, the higher probability will break this kind of uptrend, let's say. Then if something like this can happen, we can see further downside. Of course everything can reverse, but let's see, we need to trade what we see, not what we think. We need to wait for the days to close and trade the whole day in order to identify next opportunity next day. You can see price here held support on these lows and now testing days open price above initial balance high. Let's see if this could be considered a failed auction setup, and then we see further upside. We need to take out 900, so I'm still short. Let's see what will give us. So I closed the short position here. Perhaps I should have closed it further downside. I initiate some selling moves here for the continuation to the downside, which didn't happen. We can see here a failed auction setup. If price managed to go above 900, hundreds and then breaks it to the upside, we should see 930s retest as everyone would see short needs to cover, and this should create some upside and perhaps even higher later. I'm out of the position here. You can see support twice and days open price and volume weighted average price for this failed auction setup, which price sells below initial balance, then fails to hold on and continue lower, and then goes back above. You can see consolidation here, then initial rally. We need to take out this midpoint of initial balance in order to have a initial balance high retest. So you can see price now held this support as anticipated when it broke out this initial balance low, immediately rallied at the turn of the hour, now holding some resistance on this initial balance high. You can see it's simple as that, when one move happens and then fails to hold sideways or even continue and then reverse back above initial balance low, then you should seek for the higher balance of the range here, initial balance high. You can see support here clearly at the day's open price, initial resistance here at midpoint of this initial balance, then breakout of 900s, now retest of initial balance high. This is what the failed auction setup I used to call. Okay, so here we are a few hours later. You can see here price just held support once again at day's open price, rallied up to initial balance high. This is where it collapsed, as I was explaining earlier this morning, at the anticipation of this failed auction, which price fails below and goes further upside. Now, broke down this midpoint of initial balance. First, the target will be this short down to equilibrium line, which coincides there with initial balance low. If this breaks, then we'll look for a day's low retest. So you can see here this trade worked for 30 points or so, I held for further downside, now I stopped it here for 2 points, let's see if price can go further upside or if it's going to top out around here. You can see SPY kind of filled this gap and now reversed, let's see if it holds or just breaks down below 204. Okay, let's see how I traded this. I attempted 3 shorts here. The 3 of them worked for a good 30 points or so, right here, 20-30 points, which I closed them to scratch because I was expecting price to go further downside. If you would like to close this video with a big picture here, you can see just kind of reversed this position, closing around this area. Let's see if we have any gap up or gap down on Monday. If we have a gap down, we take out this loss, this should be a very nice short opportunity. On the other hand, we can just grind higher as well. We'll see.